SBDC 2011.
Happy with us, Doc Swan, the Fire University student.
Hiya. Goodbye.
A little bit cold and a little bit sunny, but mixed up together.
Hello, my name is Bobby Caballero. I am the Dean of Students here at the Elsie Whitlow Stokes School. We are a public charter school that's been in existence for 13 years, and I've been here for 10 of those 13 years.
Hello, my name is Desiree. I am nice, friendly, and take care of animals when they need help.
Our students learn in two languages, either French or English or Spanish and English. We have two classes in every grade. One of the classes is French and English, and the other class is Spanish and English.
I want to tell a joke. A man is driving on the road. He bumps into another man. He says, the man says to the other man, "Hey, this is a one-way road." And the other man says, "That's all right, I'm only going one way."
When I have a treasure hunt at home, I always win because I hit the treasure.
When I was growing up, I wanted to be a pediatrician. That changed when, after my freshman year at Howard, I joined an organization called the Big Brother Big Sister Program on Howard's campus, and I got a chance to work firsthand with students here in public schools in D.C. And for some reason, I felt a much stronger calling going into education than I did going into medicine.
Solomon and Josie.
I want to be a race car driver.
God made the pieces of everything.
A person who searches for animals and helps them and gives them food. And a person who helps other people who are poor and who don't have food.
Somebody else put the pieces God made together.
I want to be a doctor and help people to feel better.
A train driver.
A train conductor.
I want to be a picture chef and also a firefighter, an engineer, a pilot, and a chef.
When I grow up, I wanted to be a veterinarian.
I want to be a chef.
And what do you want to do?
You know, here at Stokes, we are very proud of our alumni. This year is the first year that we had students go to college. We had 20 students graduate the first year in 2004, and 15 of those students are currently in college. And, you know, it's really, really rewarding.